Hello YouTube, Austin here. Gonna do a very, very special recap for you guys. With me today is Hustle. Say hi to everybody, Hustle.
Yo, what up YouTube? Thanks for having me, Austin.
All right, yes. This is Immoral Family. Immoral War Family, first arranged war. In the background already, you should see some replays going on, town offense and whatnot. So yeah, Immoral Thieves and Reapers merged with War 101, and this is our first arranged war with playing with COC. Hustle, have you now, you guys in War 101, you guys have been a part of DWA for quite some time now, haven't you?
Yes, we have. We're probably like one of the original members in the DWA.
Nice. So, and then now for the Thieves and Reapers and stuff, this is our first arranged. How many have you guys done?
With the DWA, I have personally done three of them. I believe there's four arranged wars that went out, but I wasn't in the last one. I've done three of them, and just an awesome place to really fine-tune attacks and, you know, try some different things that maybe you wouldn't really do in a normal war, but
yeah,
it's really awesome.
I think I can't speak for everybody in the Thieves, but I know I had probably the most fun with this war than I have in recent memory. You know, you get a lot of the farming clans, or just huge mismatches not in our favor where we don't have a chance. This one, we did have a chance. Like,
There definitely was a chance. You know, being in our first war together as a family in the IWF, you know, definitely we had some setbacks, but, you know, nothing that can't be fixed. But, you know, together in the first arranged war to really kind of test, I was really happy and quite surprised that we were actually in this war. You know, I was actually, yeah. I was pretty much afraid. I didn't think we would have do as well as we did, but, you know, surprisingly, we came out strong and worked pretty well together, you know.
Yeah.
Just clean up a little communication things, and, you know, who knows what's in store for us.
I think if we, I mean, hats off, like, first off, hats off to PWC playing with COC.
Absolutely.
And everybody, I think Joey was our kind of numbers guy and who was really putting this together for us. So
Joey was awesome.
Special thanks to those guys. I know there's probably guys on the PWC side, I'm not sure who they are, but that got this going together. I think if we rematch them within like a month or so, I think it'd be a little more interesting. I think it'd be a little bit closer than what it was. I think we ended up losing by 2 stars, and that had to do with our Town Hall 10s. Like, it was our inability to triple their 10s.
They had two of our Town Hall 10s tripled,
yeah,
and we didn't have any of them. And we, you know, we 3-starred all the Town Hall 9s. Our Town Hall 9s came to play.
Yeah,
that was huge. That war. It was awesome.
Huge. Our 9s being able to take out their 9s was absolutely monster. And so we have, you know, it was literally just the 10s.
Yeah.
So we will get that situated and figured out for the next arranged wars and everything like that, and hopefully be able to get a win in one of these. So.
Yeah. Well, I'm not worried about the wins. I know they'll come eventually, and with more time together, and we're. We can really gel, you know. We were a week into the merge, so
yeah,
people still needed to actually get to learn who's who and who's what account and who can do what. So
exactly.
We had three wars, I believe, or two or three wars as an actual team, and then we had the arranged war. So that was like our fourth war, and you know.
Because I know I was a part of the combined in Thieves when the 101 members came over, and then we did the same thing in 101. I believe I recapped both of those, I'm pretty sure. And then, yeah, it's like just throw us into the fire kind of thing, like get everybody in. So,
Yeah, I was definitely one of the guys when merging was being discussed, and before we even merged, the idea of having an arranged war with PWC was out there, and so we knew they wanted to be one of our first, if not the first, arranged war clan we went up against. Even giving us some advice and pre-merge and everything, and I was not really for it. I was kind of I was a little more intimidated. Didn't really want to go up against such a hard clan. And, you know, hats off to them. They still gave us an incredible war.
Yeah.
And, you know, I think it was just more or less I was surprised at how well our guys did. And even though I was a firm believer in this merge, I was one of the people that really kind of pushed this merge. I knew at that point after this war, I was like, we're set, man. We're going to be good. Me being one of the Town Hall 10s that was not able to three-star, you know, it was a little bit of pressure on my, you know, first arranged war together, and
it was,
you know, it was hard, it was tough, and you know, I failed. I think I got two like one stars this war, and I'm like, come on, you know, like I'm better than that.
It was a learning experience though too, because like looking at their strategy as far as how they handled our Town Hall 10s was interesting and very, I mean, it's nothing that we haven't done before when going for three stars on Town Hall 10s, but the way they did it, you know, they sent a couple Town Hall 9s to at our bottom 10s to try to figure out certain, you know, queen walk, where is she gonna walk, and it was a scout, but it was like it was more than just like sending, you know, 45 hogs or whatever to reveal bombs. It was like, let's scout the walking path, and let's scout specific things to where then the Town Hall 10s could come in and try the same attack, but with their heroes and their spells, and really actually go for that three star.
That makes a lot of sense strategically. It's like, what, you know, I never really thought about it, but kind of basically scouting with the attack you would be going in with the real attack, you know what I mean? So it's like, here's what you would do, and everything's just going to be more powerful, so it's just going to go even better if it worked, you know. Otherwise you're like, oh, you know, if it doesn't work, then you're like, oh, screw that plan, we're going, you know, whatever, the opposite way. But absolutely.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, building off of each other's attacks, and that comes down to kind of synchronizing, I guess, or being
everyone on the same page. That's all it comes down to. Communication, exactly. Everyone being on the same page. We all have the same goal. Exactly. You know, so if me being a Town Hall 10 and like one of the Town Hall 9s work together in that specific war, we could have maybe taken down a Town Hall 10.
Yeah,
you know,
exactly.
Like, you hit it this way and try to do this for me, and then once I see how it goes, if it goes well, boom, that's what I'm gonna do, you know.
Exactly. Like, this is this attack right here, this is me going in on Gaston. That's their bottom 10. I was kind of, because I was thinking,
this was a great attack,
and it really could have gone the distance. I don't know, I maybe dropped my loons a little bit too early and stuff like that. Like, I just didn't, I felt like, let's, let me, I think we were overthinking that base, and I just wanted to just see if my heroes can overpower it, kind of my idea was.
And usually it works. Usually that idea is, I mean, usually the 40 royals are usually good enough, man.
Yeah, a few little changes here and there, and we actually had that idea, like, let's see if one of our lower 10s can do that attack and see what we need to edit, but we went away from that. I think we just spread it too far with our 10s. We were trying to 3-star too many bases. Like, let's just figure out which bases we need to 3-star and then go.
Yeah, and we overall, I think we just wasted we all saved too many attacks till the end. Like, I think we had maybe like 9 or, I don't know, I don't want to guess, but we had quite a few attacks in the last few minutes of the war.
Yeah.
And I mean, and even like longer, like even like an hour in, we were probably like around 10 attacks or something that we had left, and it doesn't seem too bad, but it definitely, in hindsight, it was like, oh, maybe we waited too long. We should have planned. And I take full responsibility of that, you know. But like I said, first war in together, we didn't want to step on each other's toes and be like, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, this is, at the end of the day, supposed to be fun and a learning experience. And so it wasn't necessarily all about the win, even though it always is at the end of the day. It was more of like, let's get to know each other and have a great time and do our best against a badass clan, you know?
Yeah. It's not like we were embarrassed by these guys. It was just a 2-star difference.
Yeah.
And that is, I'm still proud of everybody that was involved.
Heck yeah, for sure, man. Me too. Proud of everyone except for myself.
Oh, no.
But I've made up for it in other wars. But it's just, or of course, it's just the pressure. It's just, you know what it is, like, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah, oh yeah.
You can give me a farm war where it doesn't mean anything, and we're already winning by 85 stars, and I'll 3-star all the time.
Yeah, I mean, I think the war after this, I had both my main and my mini in, and I had 394%. That was the breakdown video that I just posted not too long. So yeah, nice. I understand, like, yeah, once there's no pressure, like, it's easy to 3-star.
Anyone can do it.
So yeah, let's start talking about a couple of these videos. This is Cass, just 3-star, this guy with the Valkyries, Hero Walk Valkyries.
Yeah, I love Valkyries, and the Queen Walks have been awesome. I'm loving these attacks. Here's another Valkyrie attack.
A Horde, and this one came down, like, there was no hogs left and stuff. I mean, it was, well, and both these raids, I don't know about Cass, but I know this one was, this is a fresh attack. Like,
kind of came down the last second.
Yeah. Yeah. It was just really just relying on the heroes and getting a little bit lucky with some of the stuff, which is, you know, that was clutch when you need it. That's what happens, you know? But very interesting. The 2-jump strategy is really pretty cool in my mind.
Yeah, you don't really see a lot of people as Town Hall 9 coming in with 2 jumps,
yeah,
and 2 heals. This is definitely a strategy that isn't used a lot. The Valkyries are hidden behind the Town Hall there, but they're still all pretty much full health.
A couple of them got flinged there, but they're utilizing that jump really well. And that, I guess, this is the thing about these Valkyrie attacks, is like, you need those spells to not only cover your Valkyries and your kill squad, but also your back end hogs. You're really utilizing those spells more than what they would be in a straight up go-ho.
Yeah, and those Valkyries also trigger that double giant bomb trap. They're both of the double giant bomb traps, so the hogs were used more surgically to take out the outer defenses,
yeah,
where the Valkyries were to take out more of the core and kind of...
And the Skellies.
Yeah, and the Skellies. Exactly.
They are absolutely awesome at taking out the ground Skellies, which the hogs will just get eaten up. A little bit lucky here, his Max Golem survived the whole entire raid and is going to tank for this cannon, while his back end wizards are coming around. I think he's got one more Valk also.
Yeah,
with the king.
Talk about the timing. King.
Just pretty lucky in my mind. I mean, you know, gets that cannon down, and then the Archer Tower is shooting at the Valkyrie, which is going to tank some more, and then boom, there's the 3-star. That was fucking awesome. Love that.
Yep, and you know what? You say it's lucky, and you know what? I completely agree, but in this game, at the end of the day, you need luck, and if you don't got luck,
yeah,
good, get out of here.
Yeah, and, well, you just can't, I mean, it's easy for, you know, modern clans to be able to practice these attacks all the time and see exactly how things are going to work, but if you're not, if you're fair play, like DWA and Moral Thieves and everything, you can't plan for every little thing. It just... It can't. No matter how hard you think about it, you can't play for all that.
No, at the end of the day, you're kind of just hoping for the best from, you know, your past experience and things like that. But yeah, you need luck, and just kind of like how I feel like on other things, it's just, you can have all the skill in the world, but if you don't have any luck, you're not going to get very far, I promise.
Yeah. And this is, so we got Fingers here on Kevin's base. Fingers had a really nice wall break there. I don't know if you guys saw that. And then saw a lot of the PWC members with the Max Golem in the Clan Castle.
I've seen it, and I didn't expect to see it from them.
I've even tried it. I don't know about you. I've tried it, and it's not worked well for me.
I every time I've seen it, I have not liked the way it defended, personally. But I guess at the end of the day, it comes down to these customized bases that these specific people have.
Oh,
so.
Definitely.
You know, these bases probably see a lot of certain attacks, and I guess against those certain attacks it may do better. Something like hogs or...
The only thing I can think maybe why it's so, like, because they used it a lot in this war. Like, I don't really agree with the Hound in the CC for Town Hall 9, because you're so prone to the healer archer thing. That maybe the Hound is, or the Golem there is kind of the same idea, but you're not going to get that value out of it. You're not going to be able to pull it off to the side and just distract it for the entire raid. So, I don't know, maybe some of our heavy nines should adopt this Clan Castle. Sure.
I mean, yeah, you can always, and it doesn't hurt to try it out and see.
Yeah, it's...
Especially as a couple of our talent lines. And personally, I'd rather see more... diverseness in the actual CCs, like,
yeah,
I don't like that even some of the Town Hall 10s even have, like, you know, hounds, all hounds on there. Like, at the end of the day, you want to surprise them, and I know it's not going to be a surprise for the second or third or fourth attack, but at least you kind of prevent the first attack from being something too crazy. Especially if you switch up the CCs, you know, like, I feel like Hounds is pretty much well known, and if you go into any kind of war, especially like a farm war,
yeah, it's gonna be a dragon,
you know,
or a hound.
You know, there's gonna be dragon or hound or loons, and you can just plan for that easily every single time, and
right,
and be right 90% of the time.
So we got Magic here with a very weird attack. Magic is one of the 101 members, or where did Magic come from?
He, I believe, was a sub.
Oh, a sub. Okay.
I think he was a sub from, I can't remember the clan, to be honest.
Just
I
one
forgot.
Of the DWAs, yeah.
Yeah, one of the DWA clan, yeah. And you know why it's a weird attack? Is because it's going up against Groth with a weird base.
Groth has a super weird base, but if you, I noticed
Groth always has these awesome, weird-looking bases that just blow your mind. You're like, I don't even know what the hell I'm looking at.
This attack, though, is coming from, like, the complete opposite side of the queen. I couldn't believe how far they started, where Magic started this. And to get the queen on, you know, the opposite side. I don't know if I would have ever thought about something like that, you know. It's really fun to watch.
Absolutely. And you know what? This base was prevented, this type of attack coming from the direction you would think it would be,
yeah,
which is on the queen side. So,
yeah.
So the fact that, you know, the base kind of forces you to go that way, but most people wouldn't do it because they'd probably be too scared to do it, and they probably wouldn't think it works. You know, 30-30 heroes though also helps. So.
Oh yeah, definitely. I don't know. This couldn't have been a fresh attack, but even that he didn't even heal his hogs there. He just showed off with his heal over the Clan Castle there at the end. Here's another one. This is Joey, queen walking here. So this is Joey, who helped set up this war. IWF member, longtime thief. This definitely had to been clean up the loon over there on the west side, take out that hidden Tesla. So this is another crazy one.
I love watching Archer Queen walks, but I can't plan for them. I'm not.
I tried one in 101. It was no fun.
I mean, I try it. I use it practice in like my farm for like dark elixir, but wars, I feel like too risky for me.
Yeah, definitely. I think that's
too... But they are fun to watch. And there are some people who are really good, like Joey here, who just...
Joey, Azza, they're both excellent. I think they're going to be really great Town Hall 10 attackers, too. If they have these very skillful raids already down, it's not going to be a far stretch for them.
This is what you need for the Town Hall 10. You definitely need the Queen Walk with the hybrid attacks.
Yeah. Yeah, I completely agree. I mean, there's so... Because you can get so much out of just your queen and your healers out of that troop space. You can get so much, but it's very risky. You could also get very little out of that.
Yeah, big risk, big reward. The way that I think the game was kind of intended, but I don't know. Some of these attacks, it's just really mind-blowing to watch and just see how these guys come up with these new attacks, you know? But this not being too new, but just, you know, just their own variation of it, you know? No one said that this is the exact army to do this, you know?
Yeah, like, even the double rage for the queen, like, how come up with that kind of, like, how do you know? That's so crazy to me.
Yeah, that's just like that's like his safety net. He's got two safety nets right there. You have to bring those rages for the healers, because I think you don't know at the end of the day. You really don't, but you kind of, we don't know also if it was a first or second hit, so maybe he knew that
it had to have been a second hit. He knew that Tesla was out on the west side. It had to be a second.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. So he would have... It would have been the second hit, so he would have known that those Teslas, that kill spot right there, would have had those three Teslas. So probably bringing a rage for that, knowing that Archer Queen was going to go down at some point over there.
And that's the other thing about these healer walks or queen walks. If you get too much on your queen there, you need to rage those fairies. You have to do it. They're not going to be enough to queen alive.
Oh yeah.
So yeah, we got AL Hero. This was a recruit that came into 101 and felt comfortable about bringing him into this war. Forget what clan. I think, was it a Reddit clan or something like that that he came from? You know?
I'm not sure.
I don't know. He came from a war clan outside of the Immoral family, outside of, I think even outside DWA. Really nice attack though. I like how he kind of gets the queen and clan castle aggroed and then just rushes his hogs in there. That is something that I don't know, a lot of people don't do. They just kind of let their heroes die, and it's like, if you get what you need accomplished, then go on. Yep. You know what I mean?
And he's got the full health Archer Queen at the end here, so. Well done there. That was a nice attack.
Oh yeah.
It's always extra icing on the cake when you got your Archer Queen full health.
Yeah, made that look easy.
Back to back bases. It looks like he took out this one too, AL Hero.
AL had a nice 6-star for him. I think a few of our members did. Should have probably went in there and wrote down everything. Alright, sorry for those who got 6-stars and know they got 6-stars.
Yeah, there's always next war. We're learning too. And
yeah, and
not only with our war strategy, but also with our YouTube strategy.
Yeah, definitely. That's a little bit weird too, because we kind of had an agreement with PWC, because they're actually in war right now with One Hive. So if they were able to see all these bases get 3-starred, then they would have no problem. So we're delaying this for them, for PWC to help them out pretty much.
Yeah, being in a war against another major clan, or a ranged war against another major clan, didn't want to give them an advantage. Just delaying our, basically, our when we're going to release this. So no big deal. Doesn't, you know, whatever we can do to help out.
Yeah, yeah. And, you know, best of luck to both the clans. I'm sure it's a great war. I don't know if anybody's streaming it, or I'm sure they're going to recap it, but I don't know if they're...
Yeah, that's going to be, I think that's going to come down to it too. Probably the percentage.
Percentage or triples, Town Hall 10 triples, definitely. So, pretty cool here, because AL had that Go Heroes Hog Raid, and then a max attack here, or modified max attack, kind of spread out base. So
doesn't get the full health Archer Queen though. No, that was the difference.
But he keeps her alive though. You know, you keep your heroes alive, and you got a good damn chance of getting a 3-star.
Respectable.
Here goes Kai. Like, probably gonna be a stoned Goho, is what I imagine.
It looks like it.
Yeah, I wish more people would do this. Kai is really good about setting his wizards outside of his golems and letting his queen clean up the middle in between areas. I think that's a powerful thing. You want your queen down, like, immediately, kind of. Like, she's so strong, especially when you upgrade her, and he's got level 30 heroes. Get her down. Let her start doing stuff.
How about this clan castle? Just all the way in the corner, and another golem out of there, so you can see the royals taking down the golem there. And it just broke. So, I mean, you know, look at how long it's being distracted. Doesn't do very much damage, similar to the hound. But it did distract them, and if, you know, there were actual towers hitting them, that could be a problem there. But as you can see, the golem was just staying in front.
The other thing about the golem too is, like, the Barb King will actually, like, the Barb King doesn't care about a hound. He's not going to shoot at the hound. But a golem, he will get distracted by that hound. And if you're using your Barb King to take out a queen, and he's sitting there beating on a golem, that might cost you your king if it's a close matchup, you know. Between the heroes.
Yeah, and then he just kind of overpowers here with surgical hogs, and just he's got a whole mass, and all he does is need to throw it on a heal once in a while here, and
yeah,
fine. No double giant bomb spots here though.
Which is interesting. I see a lot of the Town Hall 9s going away from the double giant bombs. I'm not
using the singles. I'm sure they're both valuable in certain times in wars and stuff, but I just personally love the double giant bombs. It's just something that hogs have to deal with. And
I want to say it maybe has to do with, like, if you ran out of heals, but if you were stretching your heals much,
then, like, if you're coming in with this type of attack right here, where you have a jump, a rage, and two heals. Now, if you drop one of those heals early, and then you got two or maybe three other single spots left, there's no way you're going to be able to heal through it. It's just a matter of time.
Yeah.
So I do understand the strategy behind it. It's just, I just love the double giant bombs. I think they're more of a pain.
Well, they're definitely more potent. Like, you can't, there's nothing you can do other than running over it with your kill squad. If you can't do that, then,
And this kill squad going straight into the kill zone here, Teslas, you know, Town Hall 9 Teslas, you would think this little zone took a while to clear. Yeah. You would think that would just be taken down, but.
I like the giant. There was three point defenses on that north west side. Some people are going away from the giant to tank. That one worked out great. Really like that.
Still got both of his golems full health, just sitting there now. Not really gonna matter anymore, but just to show you how powerful that kill squad went in there.
Yeah, definitely. K King kind of fizzled out, but they're not a big deal. You still got a couple of those witches too, which is going to help clean up. And then some back-end troops, obviously. That's kind of par for the course. Like, you want to get a triple at Town Hall 9, you...
That's Joms from War 101. That's like a standard attack for him. Like, he probably just queues that up in his sleep and just...
Yeah. There goes another really just, like, these base designers in PWC. I don't know if these are, they're getting them from other people, if they're just, they have a base building team. I don't know, but they have some really, really weird bases. I think, this is Azza going in, gonna queen walk here. I think he's even got skellies on the outside. If I remember this raid, he's got skellies to try to distract the queen walk. I don't know that I've ever put skellies on the outside. How about you?
No, I never have put skellies on the side, but yeah, I think if maybe if you put a Tesla right there, like right where the queen is kind of now, like maybe put a Tesla there so that they have the cannon, the archer tower, and then the maybe a Tesla there, then some skellies right there, I think maybe the could do some damage. There. Yeah, see, more skeletons. Yeah, I don't see, there's no point defenses though. Even on the base design, I didn't really see like where he dropped it. He dropped it right on two wizard towers. So not too many point defenses, or high, at least high point defenses that just could really matter.
There we go again with the golem and the clan castle.
Just got a wizard over there just beating up.
I'm super on the fence about that. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing.
It's not really doing anything. The Archer Queen is just going at its, you know, doing its thing, and got a little golemite just distracting the CC the whole time.
Did you see the hogs take out that mortar and then run right into that giant bomb? That was awesome. I mean, now it's just the air defense. The air defense is not.
I missed that, actually. I was watching the CC goal.
Man, that was beautiful. There's actually a hog up there on that.
The lone hog. He's working.
He's got no problem. But this was another one of those, like, cross the base, get the archer queen raids that... baffles me. It's amazing stuff that what some of these guys think of, man.
That was a nice attack. Here's Joms with a six Joms attack again. Look at this standard army. He brought an extra witch this time though.
I think again coming all the Archer Queen is down all the way. If I remember this raid correctly, it's like go wee wee down the middle with like flanking hogs. But to come across the base, all the way across the base. I've done this, I'm not gonna lie, I've done this to a Town Hall 9 with my Town Hall 10. To where I'm like, well, my golems and heroes can walk across the space. For a 9 to do against a 9, that is so sick. That is ridiculous to me.
Yeah, and you can just tell that this base has been designed for the opposite of this attack. Like, you want to kill the base, the owner of the base wants to have your attack start at the bottom. He even puts the town hall on the outside for you, just so you can start your queen over there.
A town hall down there, a bunch of storages and everything. Like, yeah, they want you to just do whatever you want to do from the bottom.
You can even see the wizard towers. Four wizard towers was in the same spot up at the top northwest of the space. And he took it down real quick with the kill swag because they just weren't going to... All the DPS damage on the defense was down here at the bottom of the space. So,
yeah, and I mean, all of his hogs are already down. The queen is still up. Now it's just really the...
He's got the golems.
The golems and the witches. You got witches running around. To take care of the rest of this base.
The witches just overran that, you know, with no wizard tower. Like if he takes that mortar out and he puts a wizard tower in there, right there, this is a different battle. It probably wouldn't go that the wizard tower would have protected from the Skelly's, and it would have been a little bit different. Probably he still would have had it though, because he does still have his archer ability. But you could see all the DPS down here at the end of the base here. So strong golem.
Did his golems survive this far?
No, they didn't survive, but they
really
got the job done.
Yeah, didn't need to get that far down, but wow. Just a crazy, absolutely crazy attack.
Got a minion, two wizards, and a witch left. That's a good attack. You got full use out of those troops in that attack. Probably stretched it as far as it would have went there.
Yeah, most definitely. Fingus here. Fingus his Valkyries. He likes his Valkyries. I remember recapping him several times in Thebes. And anytime he got a 6-star war, it was a lot of Valkyries. So he likes those Valkyries.
And you know what? It's nice in Town Hall 9, you can have max Valkyries. So that's probably why you see a little bit more. I've never used Valkyries. And after watching these attacks, I'm a believer, man. I'm not going to lie. I'm a believer.
I'm lucky to have my second account, which is Town Hall, Max Town Hall 8. And using immense Town Hall 8, like Govahos as Town Hall 8, is actually really, really, really powerful if you know what to do. But usually, a Town Hall 8, you're not going to know what to do with Valkyries. Like, I know when my main account was Town Hall 8, I didn't know. Like, I had no idea what was going on with Valkyries. I was pretty in the dark. So,
did you just see how all those Valkyries just took out that corner right there? That little square? Oh,
yeah. Under the rage, yeah.
took out the Archer Queen in there, even pre-rage right there. That was just, as you can see, these Valkyries are no joke. You get them in a bundle, and you have some close defenses and some close buildings. That splash damage is no joke. And so they do good damage, and they also tank. So multi-use tool here. One of the most underrated characters or troop in the game.
Yeah, and when I was hearing, like, this was back when I was Town Hall 9, I was hearing some Town Hall 10s talking about, oh, they want max Valkyrie, or they want level 5 Valkyrie. So I was like, why? That's so stupid. Now that I'm where I'm at in the game, yes, we need, like, I'm hearing this with this update coming up, they're going to add level 3 witches, and I'm like, I mean, that's cool, I'm sure, but level 5 Valkyries, I think, would be a huge, huge improvement to this game.
I heard that they're doing the level 6 golem this update.
That would help.
That's what I was thinking too, you know, like, just thinking about what the possibilities are, and they're endless, and we could sit here all day probably, but that'd
I'm
be
sure
really
all,
cool if we had
I'm sure
level
all
6
the
golems.
Troops sure all the troops will get a boost, level 7 balloons and blah blah blah, whatever. But yeah, as a fun utility troop, I think the Valkyries are a no-brainer.
And we are going to get that new troop too, so that new troop, that's going to hopefully change the game quite a bit.
Yeah, that's long. I feel like that's long overdue.
That's what?
Long overdue.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I agree.
A Town Hall 10 exclusive or 11 or whatever. Highly considered. Here we go, Cask. Caskazilla. Seen a few of these. Dragon suicide dragons or drag trade raids in this war. I don't know how many of the PWC guys are really defending against them, but it's a pretty strong strategy. Like, it's a very base dependent, but a couple dragons, a couple loons, and a rage, and you get the queen. Queens.
Yeah, and then now he's just got his kill squad with the other air defenses. He's got all the air defenses right here, and, you know, all being on one side like that, this kill squad can just make it, you know, just a little bit. You're probably going to get a couple of these air defenses with the sweeper, and that's all you really need.
Super late. He kind of, that jump was really late. Which maybe that's the difference between getting the jump and using the EQ, because when people use the EQ, that's the first thing they use. Drop the EQ and go on with the rest of it. I think he might have forgot that jump.
In his defense, though, it also looks when you delay the jump, the golem sits behind that wall, right? And so the expos aren't hitting it or firing on it. And until he puts that jump, when he really needs to finally get over it, then the golems move in and then the expos start hitting it. So it actually, I've seen Town Hall 10s do that where I'm like, why aren't they putting the jump yet? But they'll wait until everything kind of, the Archer Queen kind of catches up to the group, because if those tanks move ahead and the Archer Queen's still lagging behind killing the remaining buildings, your golems go down before your Archer Queen kind of gets into the action. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And so I don't know if he did it on purpose. I'm just saying, I know Town Hall 10s, even from the last war that Thieves had with that clan that was 3-star, and they, you can look in those attacks, they definitely start to drag out the jump spells. And I've never really thought of it, but I noticed it in the replays, and I don't know, maybe Casca did it there, maybe he did, maybe he didn't, I don't know. But it looked like it worked for that base.
Yeah, definitely, because I do notice that the Archer Queen will show hang back. That's a big reason why you delay the king, is like you don't want him to run in and just get completely annihilated. So maybe that's to help the flow and the time.
Yeah, look at this. Look at Big Ears base. 4 Teslas on the outside right here. Look at that.
Teslas like that. That's so dirty.
That's scary, man. Like, if that happened to me on my first deck, I'd freak out. I wouldn't know what to do. Just drop everything right there.
They took out a lot of wall breakers. Dude, luckily, Joe Mama brought enough. Yeah, that is
cool base design this war.
This might also have been a fresh attack if his reaction, judging by his reaction to those. And then Max Pekka, I've seen a couple of the 101 and Thieves members use the Max Pekka.
Yeah, this is a pretty straightforward, stone goho attack. But
with Sturgy Hogs, yeah.
Sturgy Hogs and just perfect execution. Now look at that nice heal just in time. Thankfully, there's no Wizard Tower over there, but perfect timing.
Literally, the queen goes over to the side and is away from those defenses while the hogs work their way in.
Yeah, and then he saved a hog there at the end just to distract the Wizard Tower with the one hog instead of the group. That's always key, too. You know, you don't want the Wizard Tower focusing on the group, so you just save one hog and send it in a few seconds before. You know, gives you that extra HP at the end of these battles with the hogs. So, nice attack, Joe Mama.
And then the
extra poison.
Well, the poison there, like, yeah. Plenty of cleanup wizard too, which is nice. Gotta have those. Tech here.
Alright, Tech. Waiting. He's been watching right now for an hour and he's like, finally it's here. Been waiting. Got the giant down early before the hogs there just to tank for him and keep him alive like a little bit longer.
Mini Surgy to funnel. It's golems and get the lure, it looks like.
Get the lure and take out 2-3 defenses there.
3 defense. I like that. A lot of people might not, they'll maybe rely on their wizards to take out some stuff and whatever, but that, you know, funneling is funneling. If you're funneling your heroes or funneling your golems or funneling whatever, it's all funneling. So that was mainly to get, you know, all his golems to be walking.
Yeah, definitely, definitely had a, they were used to funnel them in through the middle here and also lure and take out defenses more importantly. But yes, at the end of the day, it comes down to, these attacks do come down to funneling and kind of knowing and being able to predict where troops are going to go as you give more experience. If you're watching this video and you're not as experienced and you're looking for some things to pick up here. It, at the end of the day, it comes down to experience and kind of understanding the way the troops work. Hogs being focusing on the defenses first. Bacon.
The double giant bombs there, but honestly, he did. He got all those defenses down though, and he saved all the rest of his hogs for the surgery part up here. Has his golems up here just tanking those level 7 hidden Teslas while his hogs help clean up.
Luckily, he has some wizards in the bank still. Looks like quite a bit of amount of cleanup. This one probably went down to the wire, looks like, but just enough. Got a couple hogs left to get some of these buildings in the middle, these high hit point charges in the middle.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Those four hogs go down, and those wizards might be a while before they get there through those set of walls. So
yeah, Lego walls. Yeah.
All right, we got Ray coming here. Another 101 guy. Looks like one golem, or is there two in there?
Look like just one. Yeah, he just brought the CC one, coming from the kind of more or less obvious spot, like go in fourth
corner. Yeah, this base looks like you want you to come from this way. So a little scary, but his Barbarian King took out that Archer Queen no problem.
Nice thing is maybe he saw that, okay, there's just a Hound in the CC. This is the other reason why I don't like the Hound in the CC. Maybe the reason why they went with so many golems or P.E.K.K.A.s or whatever. I mean, this Hound isn't really doing anything.
Nope. If you charge the Hound, it usually works out better for the defense. I've started to notice that you kind of want to send your Archer Queen away from the Hound.
Yeah.
And let her do her own thing and let your troops do the own thing. And, you know, if the Hound goes down, it goes down. But if it doesn't, who cares? It's doing, what, five damage every second or whatever it is?
It's actually better if it doesn't go down. Like, right now it's doing next to nothing to these hogs.
Yeah, at this point, you don't want it to go down. You don't want it to pop. You don't want those minions to come out and start to create havoc. And it looks like we're going to have a showdown here pretty soon, but... Nope.
At 90-something percent, it's not really a big deal. Yeah, it never. I mean, that's perfect for Ray. Don't let it. Don't take care of it. It's not gonna matter.
Yeah. And who knows? We're just picking at these bases because some of these bases probably have already they know where things are at this point and stuff like that. Yeah. So we got Poopsie from 101 as well. I had to just say it like that. That's the way he enters rooms.
See, this is the other reason why I wanted to do this combined recap. Is because, since it was only a week into this merger that we did this, I don't know half the members in 101. I'm only just now getting to know some of them since I've been in 101, so... that's another great reason why we're doing this dual comp.
Absolutely, we take the best from one clan, the best, and put them in a YouTube video, and bada boom, bada bing, magic. And if any of you guys don't know, I do also have a YouTube channel, Clash with Hustle. If you guys want to come check out some more attacks from 101, I'll probably be posting regularly there as well as on this. Immoral clashing, so the more love, the better, guys.
Yeah, and I think going forward, you're gonna be doing the thieves recaps. Is this what we're doing?
I don't know if anything's set in stone at this point, but I'm most likely gonna be doing recaps. It's just a matter of where. With the current situation of leadership in 101, things may change. Been given some more responsibility as of late in 101, so
yeah,
whatever is best for the family and for the clans, I'm all down for.
Because I know I'm gonna be doing more breakdowns, like just instead of doing these mass recaps, I just want to show, like, cater to a different crowd, like show just one attack and break it all the way down, and you know, get in the mindset of like cracking bases is what I aim to do.
But yeah, and that sounds like awesome. That sounds like I think what YouTube needs, man. You know, you don't see too many of those videos, and they're far and few from each other, you know?
Yeah, but at the same time, like what I was doing, a lot of people like that stuff still. So I feel like we should, man. We have enough people, we could appease all the crowds.
And now we have Dev here from 101.
Oh, versus Jon Snow. I've seen Jon Snow in the Immoral TNA, so this is
Jon Snow. He's not dead. He's alive and well playing Clash of Clans, as you can see here, folks.
But at the same time, Jon Snow, you know nothing.
He knows nothing.
Another one of these drag trades. Is that, I think that's what it's called, drag trade or suicide dragons or something like that.
Suicide dragons, drag trade, whatever they call it, I like it. I've never would have thought of this. I mean, you know, it's weird because it's 40 troops. So it's, would you be able to kill a queen with 40 troops any other way? Like, you know, to really kind of make it heroes, into your attack. Yeah. But, you know, the drag's still up and, you know, who knows?
I think this really became a thing, or is more prevalent now that the Town Hall 9 got the level 4 dragons, which I joked about when I was Town Hall 9. I was like, oh, they'll just give us level 4 dragons, ha ha ha, because that... And they totally did, and it has grown in popularity. Like, mass dragons, I'm sure there's clans that do that, but, I mean, as far as a 3-star strategy, nobody's going to be doing it.
Yeah, you don't see too many mass dragons anymore, unless you're talking about like 2-star in a Town Hall 10 or something.
Yeah, 2-star a Town Hall 10 or like Town Hall 8, yeah, sure.
Yeah, Town Hall 8, you see drags, but yeah, not in 9s, but it's cool that they're, you know, reviving the troop, and you know, even if it's just for a specific like part of the tech, you know,
it's pretty cool. It's very much a exploit, like a base exploit. There's only a few bases that you could actually do it to, but
true,
but it's awesome. That's great that they can do.
Yeah, most bases are going to have the AQ in the center somewhere, so
next, Isaac.
Looks like a single Goho. 33 hogs. Like he's just gonna overrun this base. Hogs.
Possibly knows where. I assume with a simple attack like this, he's gotta know where the bombs are and everything.
That is a king already walking. Not sure if he meant to do that. It's all. He 3-starred, so it's all part of the plan, folks.
Yeah, right.
Holmes down. Go down between the dragon and the archer queen. Dun dun dun. Early ability to prevent the dragon from targeting him. But now we have a cannon on it, and doesn't look like it's gonna be really much of a matter with 30 hogs, like I said, just coming in too deep.
It's gonna just be gonna relying, end up overrun. Yeah.
Just overrunning at this
hugely,
point.
Hugely, with the hogs. The heroes are kind of washed. Just make sure you get, you know, the enemy hero or NPCs. Once you get those, it's okay. The hogs do what they do.
Reminds me of like a Town Hall 8 kind of a strategy, but obviously with the golem kill squad first.
Oh, right, there's the double giant bombs there, so sent enough troops into that outer lying compartment to be able to work through that compartment and get in and
good save attack, good nice rest. Attack.
Definitely. There goes poopsie again. Is that
poopsie?
This is a very weird. I mean, this is kind of a drag hoe. Go drag home?
He must have been inspired on a YouTube video or something.
Yeah, had to be. He saw something.
Did I put a drag hole on the website the other day? What happened?
10 hogs left and 6 dragons. Kill squad gonna go in.
Yeah, well, it looks like there's no air defense at the north here. I don't remember this attack either, so I'm just assuming. But there doesn't look like there's any air defense in the north there with the Archer Queen, so he's probably going to go with the drags up there and then use the hogs to take out the other two air defenses.
Yeah, there come the dragons.
Yeah, see, it's just at the end of the day, these type of strategies, you know, are based on the base that they're facing, you know. Like, yeah, otherwise, he would never use this strategy. There would be, you know, you get a symmetrical base and... You'd probably kick him for having this army.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, what is this? Missed the rage there. Oh no! He didn't get one dragon. There's the first dragon after that rage,
which is just about to die anyway.
Yeah. So
maybe stretch that rage a little bit. Could have side or the other.
I think what happened was, as though he had a couple of dragons on one side, a couple of dragons on the other side. He told himself, "I want to get it right in the middle," and neither of the dragons decided to go in the middle. Just bad luck, I see. Like I said, you need luck, you know. Nonetheless, still has that heal with the hogs that are just going to take down the other air defense and the other archer tower. And at this point,
really,
just over.
Well, the rest of his raid, he did what he needed to accomplish with each part of the raid. So let everything do what they need to do, kind of thing.
Yeah, that was a pretty sexy attack. Nice job, Poops.
Yeah, very, very creative, very different. One of the only drag go-hoes that we see here.
Was that the only one?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure, yeah. I mean, there was a few drag trades, but...
So you could even do that strategy on this base with, like, all the, you know, the air defenses on one side still, and you do a similar strategy if you wanted, but coming in with a more probably like a more redefined just a more solid attack, more that's not necessarily solid, but just better chance, kind of predict a little bit more
with the Valkyries, you mean?
Yeah,
I feel like Valkyries,
more consistent, that's the word.
They're very more forgiving too, which is something I noticed. You gotta put a good attack in no matter what.
Got the earthquakes to just blow a hole in this base, and in the spot he dropped it did open up about the three biggest compartments in the base. So you're looking at over 50% of the base from the earthquake. So good choice there to use earthquake.
And then all the little compartments that he didn't get to, the hogs are going to go in for anyway. And looks like saves one heal here for the hogs.
Yeah, they got a lot of
sooner,
health.
Sooner than later.
Probably right after this double or this giant bump going somewhere.
Oh,
the kill squad or the kill zone.
Inside the kill zone, yeah.
There's barely the spring chaps.
Barely nicked that wizard tower with a heal. Good idea. Always a good idea.
Very nice.
Is Alchemist? Is that the 101 member?
No, Alchemist is not. He's a sub. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Good raid, Alchemist with the Falcons. Only what was that? Five or six? Not a lot. Went more heavy on the hogs, which was.
Yeah, there's no real one way to one way to raid, you know. What's awesome about the game at the end of the day, as creative as you can be, as creative as you want, and you know, make things work that people may have not even thought of, you know.
Yeah, definitely.
And if it works, it works. If it doesn't, then time to think of something else. But these are just some solid attacks all the way down the map.
So we got another one of these, like, cross. Not going straight in for the queen raids. laying the golem there.
He's not going for the Archer Queen at all. He's
not I yet. Think... No. Gets the king. Kind of getting split here as queen gets ahead of his golems. I think she might have even pulled the CC. Finally drops the king though.
The wizard ended up pulling the CC, so once it died, then it kind of.
Oh, okay. Yeah, because it didn't go for the queen.
Yeah, it was interesting to use his jump there when his golems were already near the Teslas over there to the
east. Yeah, on the other side.
It was interesting. It worked out for him, though.
To redirect him, for sure.
Mm-hmm. I didn't even think the jump would have even got to him, but it did.
Finally goes for the queen, and here come the hogs.
Yeah, KVC and his 30-30 heroes kind of just really put a lot of pressure on this base. Took down his heroes easily.
Yeah, most definitely. I mean, well, this is a kind of a huge dip. It's 8 versus 29, so... But
maybe
some of the guys down there had trouble with this. I'm not exactly sure. I was more focused on the Town Hall 10s. Like, after... Because, like, when I woke up for war, like, a lot of the 9s, the bottom 9s, were 3-starred. We just had the top 9s left to go. So, I wasn't really focusing. Throughout the whole war day, I wasn't focused too much.
I think it came down for me. I was pretty busy. And then thinking it was going to... That we weren't going to even... It wasn't going to come down to 3-star on Talentons. I didn't think that was gonna be the difference. And, you know, like I said, I kind of learned from this war and definitely gained a lot of experience from it and should be ready to go in the next range war, which I'm excited to. I think it's coming up pretty soon here in the next December.
From what I heard is Joey is working very hard and has this pretty much...
Joey's the man, dude.
He's thriving over these arranged wars.
He lives for the arranged war,
which is understandable. I mean, it's best versus the best. Why wouldn't you want to do more of these? So we got Jaylee here, two jumps again with the Valkyries. Gotta like that.
This is a good jump there because if he uses wall breakers, he'll never get the wall breakers to go to that metal compartment, and they're going to go to the corners first. So, completely understand the two jumps here.
Delays that last jump to where he doesn't need the EQ because that would be an easy EQ one. Open up four giant compartments, but if he times it right, he doesn't need to.
By the time the jump goes down, the base is already dead. And then it's just cleanup time, so.
Yeah, ran into some mess there, but the surgical approach with saving some for the back end defenses was ended up being...
Yeah, not huge heroes, you know, so still a little... Still nice to see.
Boom, there it is. To the left. Valkyries go.
Sounds like you're cutting out now, but.
Oh, am I?
Sounds like it on my end, but. Go Mama had a six pack this war. This would be his second attack, second replay here. Probably, I think he's got a stone Goho.
Yeah, Archer Queen in the middle, got it like that. Some wall breakers, that's good. Break that first wall, there goes the Max Golem.
Yep, and here comes the stoned Max Golem.
I'm gonna jump into the Queen section, there it is. Nice delay on the King.
Yeah, going straight for the Archer Queen. Like a ninja, getting in there, getting in quick.
I like that too. A couple flanking hogs, get them in there quick. Care of those Teslas.
Yeah, and then see the Archer Queen just getting stuck up on the Hound here.
Yeah. That's kind of what you deal with if you take it out. That's the strength of the Hound in the sea. Pops. Plenty of golems left to tank for the queen. The hogs go through the rest of this base.
Yep, and with the max golem, that being the difference there too, the just sitting on the expo, the Archer Queen is free to do work. And we got cleanup.
Got enough wizards and stuff. So, solid raid by Joe. Joe Mama has really turned up in the last few weeks, months, whatever.
All right, we got Isaac with a six pack. Second replay for him tonight.
So kind of a modified max attack. I'm gonna go ahead and get those two air defenses by the Clan Castle. Air out the rest of it. Was that a wall breaker fail? Yeah, those Teslas.
Yeah, the Teslas.
Ruined his wall breakers.
I think he was planning on using those wall breakers to probably get into the second layer here, but
yeah.
No worries, he got the jump spell. The Archer Queen is going to start to get hung up here. Raged and use the ability.
King goes in for both of the heroes, which is nice. First Hound is going for that air defense. Going all the way across.
That was awesome. The Hound just... Oh, and it gets all three black bombs, so, you know, job well done for that Hound.
Yeah.
You always want your hounds to take out as many, one hound to take out as many of the seeking air mines as possible. It's bad when they're, in my opinion, when they're spread out.
And the red bombs, like, that's why I don't want to give all my secrets away, but when I build a base, it's like, I want all my red bombs to...
Yeah. No, tell me more about these secrets you have.
I don't want my hounds to be
we're family now. It's just me and you attackers. Talking. All right, guys, that will be on the later episodes.
Great attack by Isaac.
Beautiful attack, beautiful. Haven't seen attack I haven't liked yet.
We got some more Valkyries like that.
More Valkyries, more Queen Walks, more from Jay Lee with his six-pack this war, coming in with a second
play. More here. Double jump Valkyries, even.
Yeah,
double jump. There. Got one of the red bombs by the minion, didn't really matter. Ever since they changed the healers... The healers don't get affected by those. Doesn't really.
Yeah, I think that's the day, or maybe not the day, but that's kind of when Queen Walks were born, because
that was the start for sure.
I remember before that pre seeking mines hitting the healers. I would always have my mines on the outside of my bases. To basically hit the healers when they came in. That's what I was going for at the end of the day.
Well, and I don't know, did you ever do healer queens back then? I would do OP queen, and I would have about 8 balloons just to go in and like maybe tank a little bit for the air defenses, and especially take out bombs.
Yeah, exactly.
Now you don't have to do any of that.
Which I think, you know, I didn't agree with the change at first. I didn't like the change at first, but now as the game has progressed and the attacks have progressed, really like the change.
Yeah.
usually, in my opinion, works, or what Super Vassell has been doing lately. You know, sometimes at first I'm a little hesitant, but at the end of the day, I've liked the changes.
They're great with taking a useless troop and making it. Did it with Bob's. Did it with Heath. They like doing it.
Yeah, you're.
Yeah, Jay Leet.
Six pack. Congrats. Beautiful attacks.
Cyrus up.
Uh oh.
Look like just kind of a regular stone goho, or shattered, I should say.
Yeah, even the base kind of looks like kind of back to normal. You know, some of these guys' bases were just like so different and so cool and just like, you know, a pleasure to attack, you know, but like at the same time, it's just like, you know, I think it's harder to attack because you don't really know and you're not used to it. When you look at a base like this, you kind of already got an idea of what's going to go where.
Right. Yeah. Good use of wall breakers. He used a lot of wall breakers there. Saved himself another spell for his hogs. That's something that Cyrus does like to do, is one of the old school wall break in.
And I can respect that. I'm all about the wall breakers, man. When I can, I will take away a jump and I will use.
Whoa!
What the? Oh, yeah, throw some hogs in there. Hurry up before. So, like, let them get you. let them use that awesome OP double heal there. If you guys don't know about that strat, you guys got to check that one out.
I forgot about that. That was healing the dirt.
Boy, and he hits the double giant bomb.
You save those heals for your hogs and then heal the dirt. What is going on?
I love how he tried to make up for it. He threw some hogs down right away. Like, that was the best. It's like, I know the hogs is what he meant to put down there, but it's just fun. It just looks funny.
A super strong attack, though. Gets everything done. He has no hogs to clean up. It is a race right now.
Oh, that's great. I don't even remember watching this one. This one is awesome. Man. That is classic. And I'm sure everyone in Clash of Clan has had that happen to them at least.
Oh, definitely. Oh, definitely.
10 to hundreds of times. And I was saying,
but to go on with the raid,
I'm talking about myself.
To go on with a raid and get it done, that is key.
Yeah, and you know, I think some people at that point would just put down the game and just say, you know what, today's not the day, and just walk away. But you know what, Cyrus, more props to you, laying the law even after you mess up. I can appreciate that.
Yeah, I know I've been a victim of the rage quit. Once one thing goes down, I know I'm not gonna get it, so I just quit. Cyrus went on with it and got it done. So. Definitely props. Hats off to you. So we have Cav here.
Cav is a 101 member. A little newer member, but definitely not shy in 3-star strategy attacks. Coming with some suicide dragons here.
Not even level 4, though. He's got level 3 dragons still.
Yeah, and you know what? You see what he did there? He put the golem in there, or the giant in there, just to kind of lure out the king and the queen a little bit more for the dragon. So that was pretty cool. Otherwise, those dragons might have sat back there a little bit longer than he would have probably liked.
Yeah, and get picked off by the point defenses. Exactly, yeah.
That was pretty cool.
Looks like heroes are down, is just relying on the hogs and his wizards to get the rest of the space. Yeah,
that's a pretty nasty heal right there. So that's gonna do it for this match with that heal.
Yeah, with just the skellies running after them, the hogs are gonna be just. And the golem is tanking for that expo the whole entire time.
Go the skellies, and it's cleanup time.
Yeah, really nice raid by Cap. Two level 3 dragons. Boy, I think we only have a few more raids to watch. I'm, again, special thanks to all the guys in Thieves and in PWC for setting this up and making this happen. I thoroughly enjoyed it. Even though we didn't win, it was a huge learning experience. Sometimes it's not all about the win, even though everybody wants to win. So yeah, thanks to all those guys.
Yeah, and then just also a special thanks to anyone who subbed from either a DWA clan or even any outside member or friend that we brought in. Really appreciate, you know, we did run in with maybe like just a couple incidents where we needed to do quick subs and things like that, or couldn't find a number or wait. So making it easier on everyone here and being able to get this done by coming into the war for us. We really appreciate it, and looking forward to warring with you guys in the future as well.
Yeah, I've seen some of these subs where it was like, we need somebody within the next hour, and fucking somebody's there. So I don't know if that was the situation this war, but
yeah. I think we need to make some of these subs into actual members, wink, wink. These subs were pretty good for us. Did well.
Definitely. We got Victim here. Split Hero, Queen Walk, Queen Trade, even, I think.
I mean, and it's perfect when you got the Hound in the CC. Keep that Archer Queen. I feel like this is going to be a new trend here with Hounds being more. Basically, throw your Queen over here and throw your Kill Squad over there, and don't even let the Archer Queen even get near the Hound, and just let her do damage and work on buildings. And I think that's going to be the new trend going forward.
Yeah, and it was only unfortunate there were so many wizards over there. They ended up taking out that Hound and popping it, but didn't really matter for the rest of the raid. But yeah, I think that was the idea, is keep them separated.
Yeah, and with the new Town Hall 11 defense, even you're gonna the Archer Queen walks, I feel like, and even now the kill squads are gonna just become more and more valuable with the different Town Hall 11 defense.
Don't remind me of Town Hall 11. That is coming up too soon.
Yeah, well, we're gonna be getting the sneak peek soon, and things are gonna be changing here in the Clash of Clans world. So.
Yeah, and I'm
just
gonna be
fingers
in the
crossed it's for the best.
I'm gonna be in the forefront of those. I will be going to at least Town Hall 10.5 since I have Walls and Heroes left. So I will be right in the thick of things.
Yeah, as soon as the Town Hall 11 comes out, I'll be upgrading the Town Hall 11 immediately now. Whether I we don't know what's going to happen and what we're going to get, so I can't say what I'm going to be upgrading first, but I do know the first thing I will get will be the new hero. But as far as defenses, depending on what we get, we may get extra sweeper or
there's a lot. There's even talking about another Inferno Tower.
Another Expo, another Archer Tower, another Cannon. Who knows? So, this point, it's just going to be like, I'll be at Town Hall 11, hopefully, upgrading whatever is available, but I'm excited, personally. I know a lot of people have mixed feelings.
It'll be definitely different. It's worth, why not go for it?
and then see
exactly what's going to come from it. That was nice there. I don't know if you saw saving a rage for those hogs to get into the Teslas.
His heal right before it I think was a premature, but luckily he had that or maybe not luckily, but just that he had that extra rage really just helped him get through that that kill zone.
Sure. We got three attacks more, left. Three attacks left. Boy, we're almost at the end of this.
It's been fun, man.
This is like an exercise. This has been like real work, man.
How much are we getting paid for this again?
Yeah.
It's currently 4 o'clock in the morning here in the Chicago time zone, so I'm getting paid overtime tonight, folks.
Yeah, I think they said checks in the mail. I'm not sure.
I'll double check that. Don't worry.
Yeah, I would too. So what do we got here? Is this just a gola? Go in, take care of the queen of the clan castle. Delay the king a good amount. I like that.
Yeah, and, you know, it's nice to see an attack. You know, we saw a lot of attacks tonight, and, you know, we saw some big heroes. So, you know, it's like, yeah, anybody could do that with big heroes, of course. Yeah. Blah, blah, blah. But, well, here, you know, here we got some 13 heroes who are not as big as some of the other attacks, well, and yeah, still gets the job done.
This is our bottom guy going up. This is Dead Av going up a little bit, and, you know, playing a part in this war, getting a 3-star and helping us out, you know. So this is a beautiful thing right here.
You can barely see, but he does have a Tesla in that corner, and he threw a balloon down there just to help his giant out there. His little surprise Tesla. You could, it wasn't even in. I just noticed it when he dropped the balloon down there. So it was a surprise Tesla in the corner, caught him off guard.
I was kind of a rushed last heal or rage there, but ended up really working well. Lasted long enough.
Yeah. Nice job, Dead.
Oh, we got another bugged attacked. All right. Bugged also had a 6-pack.
Congratulations. Well done, sir.
This is the one, 60K.
Here we go. Another Tesla in the corner.
I remember there was a few of the bottom guys doing this. I think what their idea is like, let's have them fail on a first attack. They might flash it. They might flash 3-star. They might not. But this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna try to get their hogs to get to the 50%, expose that. And then have all the hogs run over there to that Tesla and get messed up by double giant bombs.
Yeah, this is an old school strategy, at least in my opinion it is, because I've seen this a long time ago, and it's definitely a big surprise, especially on your first attack. Yeah, okay. If you run into that, that's not usually gonna end well. But
this is even more weird. Like, he doesn't even get the Archer Queen. Just sends the hogs in anyway, similar to Cyrus, where, you know, he heal the dirt. Doesn't get the queen, just goes on with the raid and like, okay, let's hope for the best.
Yeah, and you know, being the number 39 base, you know the one knows that he's gonna be 3-starred. So if the make them waste 2 attacks on the base to 3-star, all the better for him. So well designed base, and it's definitely good. Smart. It's definitely all about the strategy, and I like it.
That is the bigger picture of like what they're more privy to.
Yeah.
Although I'm not sure if this was a first attack or not. I think it was, judging by he didn't account for that Tesla. Yeah. But that is a good idea to try to trick other.
All right, well, looks like we're down to our last one, and I just wanted to personally say thanks for everyone who watched and stayed with us for the entire episode. I definitely want to say thanks again to PWC for helping us with the merge, and, you know, being our first range war and just kind of showing us love in the DWA and everything there. So really appreciate that, and looking forward to more range matches and things in the future for this family. I'm really excited to be a part of it.
Yeah, definitely. Future is bright for the Immoral family, and like you said, thanks a lot to PWC, everybody. I can't thank everybody enough for getting this going. You know, looking at this raid, shame on Dead Av for what he does to this Town Hall 8.5. There's only 3 air defenses and he goes this space. This is all, he's gonna have so many troops left at the end.
Yeah, and another Tesla in the corner there with double giant bombs, doesn't matter. Got like 30 balloons to end this match.
So anyway, it looks like we just got a few seconds left. So yeah, again, thank you everybody for watching.